Hello viewers, this is Dr. Shibani Basu Dubey, Associate Professor, Department of English, the Bhopal School of Social Sciences. So today, we are meeting with the third lecture in the series of our analysis of the poem Death Be Not Proud by John Donne. Now today, as I said in the previous lecture, I am going to take up the pertinent questions which might be asked from examination perspective. This is for you like a kit which you can refer to from examination perspective. We have already done the analysis of the poem earlier. Now the themes which are evident in the poem Death Be Not Proud by John Donne, which is a holy sonnet, we can take up the themes as first is mortality. Definitely John Donne is reiterating the fact that death is inevitable. All human beings are mortal in nature. But then, that mortality, that inevitable death, we all need to accept it and not be afraid of it, because death is just a beginning to new life. The second theme which can be taken up from the poem is dreams. Now, poet has dreams, poet has hopes, and poet has plans that after death he will be united with God, and then his life after death is going to be more beautiful than what it is now. So death would be like a new beginning, and that is why he talks of dreams, hopes, and his plans. The next very important theme which has been shown in this poem is that of religion. And here I would like to mention that both Christianity as well as Hinduism, both the religions have got a reference here. Now, this concept of life after death, or after death one is united with the eternal providence, this is a Christian concept, no doubt, that Christianity treats death as a new beginning. But it is the same in Hindu philosophy also, because as per Hindu philosophy, only the body remains mortal. The soul remains immortal, which is ultimately united with the God. And then the last theme which can be traced from the poem Death Be Not Proud is courage. Now, we are bound to die. We all are mortals, but then we should be facing that inevitable death with a lot of courage. And the way John Donne is defying death, he is going completely against death. Don't be proud of yourself, death. Don't swell with proud death. So what is he trying to say? He is trying to say that we need to face the inevitability of death with a lot of courage. So these are the themes which can be depicted through the poem. So we will logically analyze how he has proceeded forth in the poem, John Donne. He says death is a slave, and then he says that death is a slave to fate, chance, kings, and distress in life. Those, he said, desperate men who tend to commit suicide. So he has said that people die because of these four reasons, and that is why death can be termed as a slave to these four things. All right, then we move on to the next slide. So he is trying to say that death is caused by war, death is caused by poison, and death is caused by sickness. People die because of war, people die because of consuming poison, and people die because of sickness. So these are the three places, he says, or the three reasons how death is caused. As I said, that in the last two lines of the poem, there is an inbuilt, closely knit philosophy of Christianity as well as Hinduism. So I explained the Christian belief that after death one is united with the eternal providence. And here the central idea is from Bhagavad Gita. According to Bhagavad Gita, the soul or atma has properties that even weapons cannot pierce, and nobody can kill that soul. That atma, the soul, remains immortal. And that is the same philosophy which John Donne is trying to incorporate in his poem by trying to defy death, that death is only able to kill this mortal body. He will be able to perish this mortal body, but the soul which is within us, it would remain immortal. And that soul is ultimately united with eternal providence. And that is how he quotes from this particular verse from Bhagavad Gita, that Lord Shri Krishna has said that the soul can never be cut to pieces by any weapon, nor burned by fire, nor moistened by water, nor withered by the wind. So all the four elements, Agni, Jal, Vayu and Prithvi, these four elements cannot hurt the soul which remains immortal. So where is the power of death? Death is not able to kill the soul. Death is able to kill only this physical appearance, physical body. And that is why death is ultimately less powerful. It is, in fact, it has no power at all. Now we conclude the poem that John Donne concludes his sonnet by saying that death need not become proud. This life is one big sleep, in a sense that just as you wake up refreshed, full of life after a short sleep, similarly, after death, you are rejuvenated, you awake to a new life. So this is how John Donne concludes the poem. Now, these are the technical details of the poem, that this is a holy sonnet. And as you know, that sonnet comprises of 14 lines. So this sonnet also by John Donne has 14 lines made of an octave. First stanza of 8 lines and a set step, the second stanza of 6 lines, with a rhyme scheme of A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A, C, D, D, C and E, E. That is the typical rhyme scheme of Italian Petrarchan sonnet. It was written in iambic pentameter, but did not strictly follow the rules of pentameter style. But then John Donne has written this sonnet in this particular Petrarchan sonnet mode. Now the poetic devices which have been used in the poem, which I have been referring to while we were doing the poem, is the first is an apostrophe. What is an apostrophe? An address to a person or personified object, not present. He treats death as a person, so that is personification of death firstly, and secondly he is addressing death as if death is a person who is sitting right in front of him. So that figure of speech is called an apostrophe. So when he says death be not proud, why swellest thou, so all these statement sentences are in the figure of speech of apostrophe. Then there is a metaphor, there are similes. So Donne is a metaphysical poet, so you will see similes and metaphors in abundance in his poems, which we are going to do in the later lessons as well. So a common metaphor in Christian writing, comparison of death to rest and sleep. So when he says that death is asleep, it is a metaphor, and it is a very common metaphor used in Christian writings. Thou art slave to fate, chance, king and desperate men. And he is calling death to be a slave also. So that slave is also a metaphor. And comparison of death to sleep and rest, these are also metaphors. Now, there are paradoxes and irony also. At the last concluding line, he says, death, thou shalt die. Now he is saying death and you yourself will die. So this is the irony of the sentence, that death, which is an end of things, death itself will have an end when one is reunited with God. And there are rhetorical questions. What are rhetorical questions? That is asked in order to make a point. So when he says, why swellest thou then? Why are you so proud of yourself? It is a rhetorical question in order to make the point that you are ultimately powerless. All right. So these are the poetic and figurative devices which have been used. So this is the last slide of my presentation. Here I have tried to make a quiz for you people. It is for you to attempt these questions, which will give you a fairly good idea about your understanding of the poem, whether you have understood the poem correctly, in detail or not. So this much for today. Take the test on your own at your leisure. Until then, take care.